Modern data engineers need to leverage large-scale datasets, which have significant complexity, privacy, and security challenges. These engineers also need to enforce strong governance and quality controls while staying up to date with recent AI and automation innovations. Ultimately, effective data discovery, search, control, and management across a wide variety of data sources is no easy task. At the core of this challenge is the concept of metadata. To leverage the power of metadata at scale, we must extract it from our datasets in an automated way. We must also know how to use advances in artificial intelligence for generative metadata approaches. This video will introduce hands-on concepts and methods related to these three objectives. While the concepts discussed are relatively cloud agnostic, we will use a specific data fabric technology, Dataplex on Google Cloud, as an example. If you're using a different data fabric or catalog, rest assured that the concepts and approaches will be similar. In the Google Cloud console, we can gain insight into the value of data cataloging and fabric tools by exploring data across a wide variety of sources, including data warehouses, NoSQL operational databases, relational operational databases, and even unstructured data and flat files stored in Google Cloud Storage. These tools are also flexible enough to control, manage, and search data in systems outside of Google Cloud. We can organize these assets into data lakes and data zones for more efficient management of permissions and easier discoverability while maintaining a unified view across a wide variety of data types. We will discuss structuring metadata with tags and tag templates shortly, but this view demonstrates the breadth of the problem and the depth of the challenge in managing real enterprise datasets at scale. In our example, we have pub subtopics, BigQuery datasets, BigTable instances, Spanner instances, and cloud storage flat files, all connected to our Dataplex system. Establishing a data fabric or data catalog is the foundational step in managing data at scale and utilizing it for valuable insights. However, this alone has limited value as datasets only have so much native metadata. By applying more advanced techniques, we can extract and infer additional metadata from the data itself. We can use Python scripts or more production-grade data engineering pipelines to scan data, extract metadata, and generate metadata through artificial intelligence. We can even leverage external services for a generative AI approach. Effectively, this means that our data pipelines will interact with our data fabric and use generative AI models, typically through APIs. We will demonstrate how to set this up and provide code in the video description so you can explore these concepts yourself. I'm now in a code repository published on GitHub, which you can use to follow along and set up any assets you're interested in for experimenting with these concepts. I've already run all the scripts to set up the assets we explored earlier in the search interface. Once that's done, we can create metadata using AI-generated descriptions and even use tag templates for structured means of attaching metadata to our datasets. Let's take a quick look at the console. We have a variety of data, including information about the data's location, format, creation, modification, and basic descriptions. While this basic metadata is searchable, it has limited utility for advanced discovery and searching. We can use structured metadata with tags and tag templates to apply even more metadata that matches our specific business context and use cases. For example, I've set up a context tag template that can be applied to datasets or parts of datasets, such as specific columns within tables. This template provides summary information, date range information, sensitivity levels for potential personally identifiable information, and additional source information. In the search interface, we can use the tag template to filter results. For example, we can search for sensitive data, which includes the business, customers, products, and purchase orders tables. We can create these tag templates and tags dynamically using the extraction and generation methodologies we discussed earlier. Let's explore the metadata attach code to understand how this is done. We begin by setting up environment variables and clients, followed by several functions to gather data that could be useful for creating metadata. For structured data sets, we might want table data. We have specific functions to get the date range for data sets derived from data scans we'll discuss shortly. We also have a function for generating tags using an OpenAI generative AI model. These methods are combined and applied to an example collection of BigQuery tables, which were generated using Python scripts mentioned in the README. Importantly, these methods are complementary. We want to use information from data profiling scans, like start and end dates, while also having the flexibility to use generative AI for metadata creation. After running this script, we can explore the related concepts in the console. Let's first look at data quality scans and profile scans. Regardless of whether you're using your data fabric or cataloging tool directly to infer this information or an external system, the concepts are the same. The high-level idea is that there's valuable information to be gained from these scans. For example, looking at the purchase orders, we can see scan history and can observe valuable information about the different columns in this dataset, such as uniqueness, frequency of null values, specific date ranges, and statistical measures for numerical data. Instead of calculating this on the fly and using complicated mechanisms to search, we want to extract the data we care about and use it in our tag templates. That's precisely what our script does. It gets the table data and infers the date range from it. This is not an ideal use case for generative AI, so we rely on more traditional data profiling methods for this task. This approach is particularly important for larger datasets that exceed the token limit for generative AI methods. The script loops through the table results, retrieves the date range, and passes it along for later use in applying the tag. The other approach we have is using generative AI. We simply access the OpenAI endpoint to generate additional fields. When we run those scripts or data pipelines, we automatically populate the tag templates and enable flexible, context-driven approaches for data analysis. For instance, we could examine the sensitivity field to see which data across our entire landscape of data assets is potentially sensitive. In this specific case, that information comes from a generative AI-based approach that analyzed column names. This is a borderline case where more traditional data scanning technologies like Google's data loss prevention might be more appropriate. However, other cases such as data summarization are perfect for generative AI. By utilizing these approaches, regardless of the technology, we can integrate generative AI and data profiling tools to make the creation and maintenance of metadata easier and more automated. In doing so, we can gain more control, discoverability, searchability, and management for our datasets. We hope this video was helpful, and we'll be monitoring the comment section for any questions. Thank you for watching.